Hey, are you considering buying the Perception Outlaw kayak and you're nervous about how stable it is? And if you're just gonna flip in it whenever you try to stand and fish? In today's episode, I'm gonna show you exactly how stable this kayak is because we're gonna try to flip it coming up. All right, guys, so out here on the creek, found a little deeper pool, and we're just gonna test the stability of this kayak. That's really what we're out here for. So if you haven't seen my other reviews on this kayak, I will link them in the end card, but you're gonna wanna stay tuned for this because we're gonna try to flip this sucker. So we're just gonna get started here. So as I've said before, standing up in this kayak is really easy. I mean, I have no problem standing up in this kayak. It's stable, it's easy to stand up in. It's got a really nice flat deck layout. So, you know, the thing with a kayak is you've got your different levels of stability. And so when you're walking on a kayak like this, it is very stable. But the thing you have to remember is that it's much more stable if you, like, if I wanna move to the front, I want to shift my weight to one side and I don't want to do anything fast. I just want to make all my movements pretty slow and make sure that I'm not just rapidly moving on the kayak. So see, if I shift my weight to one side, I'm gonna put all my weight on my right foot and I'm pretty far forward on this kayak. There you go. So I got a little tippy there. And I do not have the best stability on my feet because I had foot surgery from being in the Army and my feet aren't the best. So as you can see, I'm gonna lean to one side, lean to the other. But 9 times out of 10, when you're fishing on a kayak, once you get up, you're not gonna wanna move your feet. You're just gonna stay in the same spot. Then when you wanna go sit down, you can plop down. A thing that would really help you to be stable on this kayak and be able to stand and sit down easier is a stand assist strap. So you could put in like a loop up here in that hole and be able to pull up on yourself to stand. So I'm gonna shift over my knees and stand up. So we're gonna mess around with how stable this is. So if you look at my feet, I'm actually able to get water on the deck. Look at that. I'm almost completely up on the side of this thing. All right, there, that's the tipping point right there. Look at that. I'm basically all the way over on the side of this kayak. And it's not tipping. Now I can shuffle forward. Thing is if you keep your feet in the center of the kayak as you're walking forward, it's going to be much more stable. I can go all the way up. We'll go up here on the bow, mess around. It's going to be more tippy as you get towards the bow or the back. But shoot, I mean, really, I could stand and fish up on the bow of this thing. That's wild. So, thing to remember is every kayak will flip. It's just a matter of how much you know what you're doing. But this one is, it's pretty, I mean, I'm gonna pretty much say this kayak is pretty much idiot proof if you wanna stand and fish. So, there we go, there we go. Look at that. So I'm gonna see, I don't wanna get my foot caught in here. I'm gonna see what it takes to flip this sucker. Right. Don't say I don't love y'all out there. Whew. So I flipped it there. I mean, and I had to try to flip this kayak. So don't ever think that just because this kayak is super stable, you can always flip any kayak. I could probably flip my native Slayer Max. So we're gonna take a look at the bottom of this kayak here. So when you look at the bottom of this kayak, see that pontoon style? You've got two defined pontoons. You got one over here, you got one over here, and then you've got the center. And that's what gives this kayak that stability. And if you look at this versus the native or the bona fide, actually, it's got a lot of similarities. And I'm not saying they copied them, but it's pretty daggone similar. That's what gives this kayak the stability. Other features that you see when you're down here is you got this under recess here for a handle. You've got this area recessed right here that's for your sonar transducer. And then in the back here, you've got your other recess for a handle. And then you've got your skid plates back here that can be replaced, that you can, you know, be able to drag this kayak and not have to worry about it. So what I'm going to do here this time is show you why you always keep your head like over your kayak. So a lot of people, 9 times out of 10, when you see people that have fallen out of their kayak, they're usually reaching for something. So if I'm fishing for my kayak and I'm reaching out like this, and you get your body, it's very easy to get your body over that tipping point of the kayak. If I'm reaching for something and you get that head over, that's when you flip, guys. So if you're ever fishing from a kayak and you're thinking about reaching out and grabbing something, just remember you got to keep your head over the top of that kayak or you're going to flip. So guys, as always, I appreciate every single one of you all watching. If you're interested, I've got 2 videos linked at the end of this. One's going to be for the walkthrough of this kayak that I did when I first got it. And the other one is actually where I do an on the water fishing review of this kayak and what I think about the layout for fishing. I appreciate every single one of y'all watching. Don't forget to get outside, do something awesome. And if you get a chance, take somebody with you. And I'll see you guys in the next one. All right.